all my life has been kind of solitary, even though I'm a very social person.
Do you have a favorite piece that sticks out to you?
Well,
very good.
I always felt as though I was an artist.
It's the one thing that I know that I can do well that brings me joy, and I do it because I have to.
You're such a beloved artist. I never have a lot of people in here tonight. The restaurant's excited about it. All the Facebook stuff, people are excited to see
good.
You.
Good.
Yeah, people love your stuff.
Thank you.
I feel really honored that you're here.
I'm honored to be here.
Most of my life has been a searching, it's been a journey. I like the direction that I'm going. I need to have a space like this space where I can just go close the door and retreat and kind of be in my own world. And I've always had that.
Step into Skip Hill's art studio and you've stepped into his soul. His spirit hangs on the walls. It's propped along baseboards and scattered all over the floor.
I would do this as a kid. This is exactly what I'm doing now. And just completely forgot that as life has gone on.
This man, crouched like a child, making faces out of cutout magazine pages, has work hanging in art galleries all over the world. His forte is mixed media. In Skip Hill's hands, cutout pieces of paper, paint, hodgepodge, and markers produce works of art worth thousands of dollars.
My paintings are expensive. They're expensive because someone has gone to medical school and invested in their medical career. I've invested in my art for years, a lot in that. So I tell people straight up, it's expensive.
On this day, some of the pieces of Skip's soul are taken down from his walls and scooped up from his floorboards. They are destined for loftier display at one of the trendiest restaurants, not in another country, but in this artist's hometown of Norman, Oklahoma.
I had no idea. Local head.
I know.
It's nice.
This big space back here?
This is gallery quality.
That's why we call it a gallery. Because okay. When we opened it, we were like, this looks like a gallery. So let's just keep it dedicated to local artists. And...
I'm happy
to
be here.
But I hadn't seen these ladies. I love the ladies. I need a lady.
Skip will spend much of this opening night on his feet, fielding questions about his work from those who came specifically to see it, or from restaurant goers who wander through while waiting for their food to arrive. It may seem simple, but the simplicity of one-on-one interaction is why Skip Hill Art is on display the world over.
I have work in Argentina, I have work in Colombia, I have work in France, I have work in Holland. I'm sure somewhere in there is a country that I've missed, but I have work all over the place.
So you're kind of a big deal.
Not as big a deal as I'd like to be. A lot bigger deal than I was a number of years ago. And I like the direction that I'm going. The trip to Brazil that I took in October, November, I managed to find a gallery there to represent my work. So they have I have a gallery that represents me in Rio de Janeiro. And starting out 10 years ago was when I really devoted myself pretty much full time to making this work. I could only dream about something like that. That I would have work in different parts of, coming from Oklahoma. You know, as an artist, you think I need to move to Mecca. I need to move to New York City. For me, that opportunity, I don't know that it ever really presented itself to me. And of course, there was fear about going. But I did wrestle with the idea of I didn't want to just be an Oklahoma artist. My goal was to get outside of Oklahoma, to get my work outside of Oklahoma, to get my name in my presentation outside of Oklahoma, which is why I started doing art fairs and art shows. This piece right here evolved out of these paintings of birds right here, which evolved out of my trip from Brazil. They're much more tropical. Collage goes back to my early introduction to other artists. Romare Bearden, for me, is like a grandfather of art for me. Early African-American artists who worked primarily with collage.
Skip's soul is a night owl.
What a lovely birdie.
While most of us sleep, he is awake, on the floor, doing that which he is compelled to do.
what I really have fun with is this idea that whatever color or pattern or whatever I need is usually at an arm's length. So if it's longer than that, it's probably a good bet that I don't need it. I usually find what I'm looking for, or sometimes I have a sense of more of it finding me, but you know, because I could be flipping through a magazine looking for something else. I have something else in mind, and then something else would jump out that'll actually be better than what I had in mind. So I usually always find what I'm looking for. And strangely enough, whatever I reach for works.
As an artist, Skip Hill has phases.
So these are the most recent works, kind of floral theme. And then these paintings, this one's from like 2005. These are from 2010. So I'm kind of giving different time periods and different series that I've worked in, because I typically work in series.
Currently, Skip is in his bird phase.
And since these are lovebirds, a couple of them I'll put a heart on. That's a good space for a heart. There's another one. My earliest experience with birds that I can recall is one night my mom letting me stay up late past my regular bedtime to watch Hitchcock's movie, The Birds. And I was really taken with her doing that because she was pretty strict about getting to bed. And so I was really honored to, it was really a big deal for me that she let me step and watch the movies. But the movie itself was just really, I'm sure it left some type of impression on me, maybe even a little traumatic. But I just have this thing about their ability to, you know, just for me to consider that they can reach into the heavens, but also can return to the earth.
Birds have usually made at least a cameo appearance in Skip Hill's work since the Murrah bombing in Oklahoma City in 1995.
I think about the sculpture piece, the installation piece I did at the Fred Jones Museum after the Murrah bombing. And I created out of clay 168 birds for each victim. And I spread that over the sculpture garden at on the roof at the Fred Jones Museum of Art in Norman at OU. And that really touched a lot of people. It resonated with a lot of people. And so at that time, the birds became metaphors or symbols for people, for the victims there. And I entitled that piece, Heaven to Earth. I love where these are going. I really, really, really love these birds. And the first time I created a piece with birds, it was based on a tragedy, and so it's nice to create these, which are really more life-affirming and very, a little humor. And I certainly have no problem with pretty. You know, some people, almost as if making art pretty is a bad thing in this postmodern age. But no, I like that they look pretty too.
The term dark night of the soul is used in Christianity to describe a spiritual crisis in a journey towards union with God. But here in this studio that sits above an art gallery in Norman, Oklahoma, next to the railroad tracks, this soul that works in the night is full of a light so consistent that it surprises even its owner.
When I look at my art, it looks happier than perhaps I feel as though I am. If, I don't know if that makes any sense at all. I see a richness about it. I love the color. I love there is a degree of humor to it, a little bit of irony that I see. In my most difficult personal times, you would think that I wouldn't make any art. And yet sometimes the challenges of life bring out some of the best things in me. But what surprises me is that it's not, if I'm down about something or like many creative people are. Perhaps most of us plagued with doubts about what I'm doing or where I am or what I'm doing with my life. Still, the art comes out beautiful. It comes out positive. It comes out life-affirming. I'm like, how did you do that when you're dealing with this or you're dealing with that? That no matter what you're dealing with, the art, I mean, I'm not creating anything that's a downer or depressing or dark or morbid or morose. Whatever I put my hand to seems to have life in it, affirming life in it. So I always find hope in that. And I acknowledge that what I have is, it's not, I've cultivated myself, but the seed of itself is purely a gift from God, is purely divinely rooted is where it is, so I recognize that.
Art is subjective. We all see something different in pictures that hang on walls, and even then, what we see can depend on our moods. But no matter what you see when you look at a Skip Hill piece, know that it was born with great joy of spirit from the heart of a soul bird that takes flight from this quiet studio and soars around the world.